Hello, this is Dr. Glasbrenner from George Mason University, and in this video, we will learn how to use the select function from the dplyr package to subset columns in a dataset. We use select when we want to keep or reorder some columns and potentially discard the rest of them. This schematic illustrates how the select function acts on a tabular dataset that starts with n rows and p columns. On the left, we have use select to choose four columns. On the right is what results after applying select, which is a tabular dataset with n rows and l columns. The number l can be less than or equal to p, the starting number of columns. The structure of the select function is as follows. The first function input is the name of your dataset. The remaining inputs are where you put the names of the columns that you want to keep. We now move into RStudio server for a screencast demoing how you can use the select function to manipulate the presidential dataset. For our first task, we will demo how you can extract the name and party columns from the presidential dataset. We start by typing in the select function like so, and for the first input, we type the word presidential, the name of our dataset. We type a comma, and for the second input, we put the word name. We type another comma, and for the third input, we put the word party. When we execute this code block, which you can do either by clicking the green play arrow in the upper right of the block, or by using the keyboard shortcut Control-Shift-Enter, we see the output of this command, which is another data frame. As we would expect from the schematic we saw earlier, we are left with a data frame with just the name and party columns. Sometimes you may want to grab several columns that are next to each other in the data frame. One way to do this would be to list all the column names one by one, which is okay when the number of columns is small, but is tedious for datasets with dozens of columns. Alternatively, we can use the colon syntax to indicate a continuous range of column names. Say that we wanted to select out the three columns name, start, and end of the presidential dataset. These columns are next to each other in presidential. So the shortcut for selecting them is to use the name colon end as our second input. When you execute this, we get back a data frame with three columns as desired. If you only want to drop a column from the dataset, we can indicate to R that it should exclude the column and return to us whatever is left over. We do this by prefixing the column name with a minus sign. In this way, we can duplicate the table returned to us in the previous example. Instead of saying that we want to keep the column's name through end, we instead say that we want to exclude the party column. In our select function, we would write minus party as our second input. When you execute this, you get what you want. A data frame with the column's name, start, and end. We can use the colon syntax in tandem with the minus sign to exclude a series of columns from our return data frame. The important thing to keep in mind is that you need to wrap the range name colon end in parentheses and put the minus sign outside the parentheses. For example, to get back a data frame with only the party column, we can use minus open parentheses name colon end close parentheses as our input. Executing it confirms that we indeed get what we wanted,